These are the Christian children of Iraq. They pray using Jesus' language. They grew up in their homes and in their churches, learning about their real faith. Since their childhood, they keep the cross and Jesus Christ in their heart. They grow up carrying the same cross, and they hence offer a continuous and silent testimony. A testimony that their ancestors have lived. They are the descendants of the Mesopotamian civilization, the first people who embraced and preached Christianity, because of which they have been tortured and displaced all along the years. With a smile on her face, this little girl is praying despite the disaster that her family has been through after the bomb explosions, which killed her uncle and had her father's leg amputated, followed by the threats that caused them to be displaced from Iraq. Zuhair and his brother's case is a typical example of violence, acts and persecutions that the Iraqi Christians have been facing since 2004 till now, in a systematic and violent matter that resembles what used to happen in the first ages of Christianity. The aggressors have not taken long before they unveiled their intentions. The threats began in Baghdad when they asked to take the cross off the church's dome and off the St. John the Baptist Chaldean church's door in the Dora neighborhood. Although their demand was executed, they came back at night to smash the statues that were inside and to steal the church's belongings. A few days later, they went up to remove the cross that was still standing in St. George's Corcus, a Syrian church that had been bombed and destroyed twice. After that, the convent of St. Raphael of the Holy Heart Sisters in the Mechanic region has been occupied. Then, many bombs and acts of sabotage targeted the Christian religious institutions all over Iraq. Churches were bombed one after the other, reaching north of Iraq in April 2007. A car bombing hit a nursery in Mosul, killing a nun and many civilians, in addition to the hundreds of children who were injured. The attacks against Christians did not only affect buildings and symbols. Priests were kidnapped and some of them were killed, while some others were released for a ransom. Some were tortured, insulted, and threatened in order to oblige them to abjure their religion. Among those priests who were released after being questioned and tortured figured Father Basil Salim Yaldo and Father Raad Washan, whose wrists were burnt with cigarettes. Those who were released carried messages ordering all Christians to leave their homes in Baghdad. However, Father Rarid Kani from the Parish of the Holy Spirit in Hayyan Nur in Mosul couldn't make it when he and three of other priests were killed by gunshots while going off of the church after the Sunday Mass ceremony. This campaign has not ceased yet, which makes each one of the priests who decide to go on, especially in the isolated areas, a real martyr project. These aggressions took larger dimensions and spread out against all Christians and not only religious people. Some were accused of owning shops where they sell drinks or of working to spread Christianity. However, the easiest accusation was dealing with the occupant, since the Iraqi Christian was considered as a crusade, just like the coalition forces. Hence, threats began against every Christian individual or family by calling them over the phone, by coming directly to their homes or by leaving a written message asking them to leave their homes. The fanatics gave Christian people the choice between paying the jizya, abjuring their religion, giving up their daughters, or facing death. While some families left their homes and went to places that are more secured, some others decided to continue despite the dangers, and they haven't left until disasters took place. Karim's family was threatened by weapons by the occupants of a house near their home in Baghdad, after they hit the mother and her daughter. Later on, the family started to receive phone calls from unknown people threatening them and asking the family to give them one of their daughters. Despite that, this family tried to continue with its life, ignoring what was awaiting them, until that morbid day came.
ذاك اليوم كانت مريضة هي رجعت الساعة بالتسعة من المدرسة وهي بقد بالمدرسة لي ساعة بالوحدة عم نطلع ما فيه هي قلت لها ليش تأخرت قالت أخاف تكوني عن صديقاتها أو شيء أنا ضل بالي يعني فكان صديقاتها قريبين يعني من بيتنا فرحت يعني دغري عليهم قلت لهم ليه ما رجعت بيبيا قالوا في سيارة سودة أوبل وقفت يعني كنا بنرجع من الطريق وقفت علينا قال اثنين كانوا ملثمين بيدهم الرشاشات واثنين قاعدين بالسيارة قال شو اسمه أخذوها البيبيان سحبوها من عندنا ووجهوا رشاشات علينا قالوا بالدغري بتروحوا أنتوا على البيت ودخلوا البيبيان بالسيارة وأنا تخبلت بوقتها رجعت على البيت وخبرت أهلي وأهله وانتظرنا بلكي يجينا تليفون يعني بنعرف يعني ليه هيك عملوا نساء بالسبعة جانا تليفون من عندهم قلت لهم بدكم مصاري أي شيء يعني قالوا لا إحنا ما بدنا مصاري بدنا بنحرق قلبكم لأن أبوها بيعتبر خاين وعم سكر التليفون من يعني اخويا وهيك عم بيدق نفس الرقم ما تليفون مسكر ما بيشيلوه فاتت خمس ايام ست ايام السابع يوم يعني يوم السابع كان الساعة بستة الصبح اجانا يعني الشباب من المنطقة بيصيحوا علينا من البالكون قالوا لنا في بنت يعني دي يقولون مقتولة شامريها بالساحة أخاف بنتكم يعني كانوا يعرفون بالمنطقة بينا وبنتنا مخطوفة فرحنا كلتنا ركب الساحة شفنا ما فيها مشرشف في صدرها كلها محروم وجهها مشوه أنا عم مختص بيها وصاير عندها نزف من هيك متوفية ما سوينا المراسيحة ودفناها بالقرية مالتنا Thank you.